UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
DLL is the one which comes with .NET framework. So that is having your method, that is having your class, console class, which is having write line method to print on the, to print on it. So these are all, whatever you see here, all the DLLs or the files which you can refer, which comes with .NET framework. Okay, so there are so many files. See here, I have so many DLLs. These are all reusable components which you can use for your programming, which comes with .NET framework. Okay, so all of you able to see the system.dll inside version 4.0 folder? Yeah, that's great. I see only one response. All of you able to see this system.dll inside your version 4.0? Okay. So these are all namespaces. System.drawing. So imagine you want to do some drawings. So you have to write using system.drawing. So depending on your requirement, so for example, I want to do some file operations. I want to read a file, I want to write into your file. So in that case, I have to include system.io. So system.io is for input-output operations. Okay, so imagine if I want to do anything related to .NET, like sending an email or writing any email component or something, I have to include system.NET, using system.NET. No, for this program, so one of the question from the attendee, like, do we need to have only one namespace? It's not required, not necessarily. You can have multiple namespaces here. So as I said, if you want to do any file operations, I need to include using system.io. Like this. If I want to read a file, write into a file, I need to include this. So depending on my requirement, I have to write this namespace here. Okay, so for now, why I'm using this system is because I want to use this console class, which is actually present inside system. Okay, so all these files, whatever you see here, all these DLLs, whatever you see here, constitute your framework class library, constitute your .NET framework library. So all these files, whatever you see here inside this framework version, so you see system.threading, you see system.web if you want to work on web application. So all these things, system.windows for Windows applications. So all these things are called .NET Framework Library. .NET Framework Library. So library is something like which can be reused. Currently we are using system namespace. Can some of you ping me any other namespace which you are seeing inside this folder? Any namespace other than system. Other than system.dll, any namespace, can you ping me? System.web, it's not we, right? I got one response, system.web, system.io.dll, system.service model, which is used, very good, system.service model. So system.xml, I don't think it's a DLL. So let's see, someone pinged system.xml. Yeah, we have system.xml.dll, right? System.io, system.runtime. So these are all called as .NET Framework Library. .NET Framework Library. Okay. So now, can someone tell me what is a namespace? Can you ping what is a namespace? What is a namespace? Yes, I got one response, collection of classes. I also told a namespace is also collection of classes as well as or collection of namespaces. Okay, so console is present in which namespace? Console is present in which namespace? Yeah, console is a class which is present in system namespace. System namespace. Okay. So whenever you're typing, ensure that C sharp is case sensitive. So you need to type like SYSTM system. So you need to respond saying like it is. Yes, one of the question I got saying like system.net.http.dll. Yes, that is also a namespace. Okay, all the DLLs which are present here are namespaces. Only DLLs. Okay. Okay. So one more thing. What does DLL stands for? Can someone tell me what does DLL stands for? You are seeing lot of DLL files. So yeah, static alter later. What is static? See now. Don't worry about public static. I will tell later. So DLL. You are seeing lot of DLLs here. So DLL stands for dynamic link library. DLL stands for dynamic link library. Okay. So these are all DLLs. Now question. Another question. Console is a class which is present in system namespace. So that is the reason why I'm including this here. Now, writeline is a method which is present inside console. So now we are done with the program. So this is the normal syntax. So I'll remove this. So I'll make one of you as presenter. So can someone type this in the notepad? Who wants to take this up? I'll make yourself as presenter. I just want someone to type this in the notepad. I'll give 5 minutes time. Who wants to take this up? Okay, Sandhya, you want to take this up? Okay. So I'm making one of you as presenter just to see that. So we'll see the mistakes and we'll try to correct it. So I'm making one of the attendee as presenter. So right click on this. I'm making Saroja as presenter. Is it fine? Shall I make you as presenter? Who wants to take this up? I just want the same code to be typed. Okay. So I'm making you as presenter. So just to make the class interactive, I made her. So all you need to do is you need to share your screen, share my desktop, and then you need to open the notepad. So one of the student is going to type it on the notepad. So you need to share your desktop before starting. Yeah. So I guess all the we are still not able to see the desktop. How about others? Are you able to see the desktop of Saroja? Yeah, now we are able to see it. Yeah, thank you. So how about other students? Please ping me if you are able to see the desktop. Okay, great. So like this, I'll make. So the first line we see some mistake. What is the mistake? I told already C sharp is case sensitive. Yeah, system using system SYSTEM. Okay, great. And then what we need to do using system? Very good. Class sample, perfect. Okay, and you need to write flower brackets, and then we need to write public stat. We need to write public static void main. Don't worry if you're not getting what is static, what is void, what is public now. So anyone sees any mistake? No need of args. You can remove that args. Args is optional. I'll tell later what is args. So anything mistake in this line? Yeah, I see some responses. There is mistake in this line. So no, public P is small letter, but I told for main M is capital. But in other programming languages like Java, C language, M is small letter. Okay. So now, again, there is one small mistake. Console C is capital. Okay. Very good. Very good. And inside right line, we need to write. We need to write hello world. Yeah. So like this. Hello world. Okay, very good. So now there are very minor mistakes here. Okay, first thing, let's try to understand. Let me explain. So using system, S is capital. We are using the system because you have to use your console class. So console class is present inside your system. So you have to write that using system. Okay, good. So now, one more thing which you should keep it in mind. So normally, all the class names, we will give first letter as capital. That is a naming standard. So if you see here, class sample, which is our class, we can give, even though you can give small letter, it will not do any error. But here, we follow some standard, so we'll write S as capital. Okay, well and good. Now, after that, we wrote public static void main. Very good. And M is capital, and static void public all are small letters. That's correct. Console C is capital and right line, one of the students is correcting it. So right line W is capital and L is also capital. Okay, so this is how we normally, very good. Thank you very much. Thanks for writing this code. So let me take the presenter role. Okay. So now let me share my desktop. So now that we are done with the code, we are done with this program. So now let's try to compile this. So what I'll do now, I'll save it. So I'll go to my computer. I'll save it somewhere. I'll save it in D drive. Inside D drive, I'll create a right click new folder. I'm creating a folder called H2K. Now inside this folder I'll try to save it. So what I'll do is file, save as, I'll go to my computer D drive inside H2K. I will save this as all files. I'll select all files and then give 1.cs. Okay, so I save this file as 1.cs. So can someone tell me, unmute yourself and tell me what I should do if I don't see this extension. So if you want to see the extension, okay, I'll tell myself. So what you need to do here is, you need to go to organize. Sometimes you might not see the extension. So if you want to see the extension, what you need to do is go to organize, click on folder and search options, and then click on view, and then uncheck this option, hide extensions for known file types. When you uncheck this option, you will be able to see the extensions. Okay, you will be able to see the extensions. Sometimes what happens, right, people, students, what they will do normally is, for them, these options would have been checked. So I get a lot of questions. Sometimes you will not have the organize option. So sometimes what happens is students will create, see now, I'll create a text document, new text document. I'll create 2.cs. So even though I change this to .cs, this is actually not .cs, not .cs file. If you see the properties, this is actually a text file. The name of this file is 2.cs.txt. So in that case, if you want to change the extension of this, what you need to do is you need to open this file, save as, you need to select all files, and then you need to give this in double quotes. Or this is one way to do it. Anyway, so now I created 2.cs. Okay, so So now if you want to see the extensions, see here, I'm not seeing the extension for text file. See now, right click on this new text document. I'm not seeing the extension. What is the extension for text file? It is .txt. So what I need to do if I want to see the extension, click on organize, folder and search options, click on view, uncheck this option, hide the extensions for known file types, apply, okay. Now I can see that this is a text file. Previously I was seeing only 2.cs, but now I'm seeing 2.cs.txt. Okay, anyway, that's okay. I'll delete this, all these files. Okay, so now I have only 1.cs, which is my code. So now let's try to compile this. So let's try to compile this code, how to compile this. So now, copy this path, d:h2k, go to your command prompt, and then you need to go to that folder. So how to go to that folder? So I need to type d:. So now, the moment I type d:, I'll come to d:. Now I created a folder called h2k. So if I want to go to that folder, cd h2k. Okay, so now what I need to do is I need to compile my code. So how to compile? I'll repeat again. Don't worry if I'm going a bit faster for now. I'll repeat this again. I'll ensure that all of you got this. So now what I need to do is csc space 1.cs. So this is your C# compiler. So C# compiler is CSC. CSC is C# compiler. So you need to type CSC followed by 1.cs. 1.cs. The moment you press enter, it will compile your C# code. It is compiling now. Compilation is done. The moment your code is compiled, did you notice anything? One more file got added, 1.exe. One more file got added. Let me delete it. I'll show you again. I'll delete this file. I will compile my code again. I'll repeat again how to compile it. So Windows R, I'm opening command prompt cmd. Once I open command prompt, my 1.cs file is present inside d drive h2k. So let me go to d:, and then type cd h2k. CD is like come to this directory. So I am now in h2k directory, which is same as where I created 1.cs. Now what I need to do is I need to type csc space h2k.cs. This is how you normally compile a C# file. So sorry, why I'm getting, so it is not h2k.cs. What is the file name which I gave? So it is actually 1.cs. okay, so now let's try to modify this. So csc space, let's try to modify this, let's try to change the code, change the compilation, csc space 1.cs. so the moment I compile it, you can see that one exe file has been created. So now if I want to execute this, all I need to do is I need to type 1. See, now I am seeing output hello world. Okay, so this is how you need to compile your C# code without using Visual Studio. Okay, so in interviews, normally when I go for interview, when I take interview also, the first question if I ask is, I want to create a simple C# program. Do I need Visual Studio? So most of you will tell, yes, I want Visual Studio. You don't need to have Visual Studio. So if you want to write simple C# programs, all you need to do is Notepad and .NET framework, because inside .NET framework you will have compiler. What is C# compiler? What is the name of C# compiler? It is CSC. CSC is the C# compiler. CSC. Okay. So now, who wants to take it up now? Who wants to take this up and who wants to compile this code? So I'll make one of you as presenter. Who wants to take this up? Okay, so I'll make Bhavik as presenter. So let me see whether he can do it or not. Okay, so I click on this, change role to presenter. Okay, so one of the students, I'm making Bhavik as presenter, so he's going to show us how to compile a C# program. So we are just seeing your screen. Okay, great. So now, all of you please please see here. So you can create a simple, don't give lengthy names, give some simple file name. Don't give my first C# program like that, yeah. And also don't give big folder names, give some simple folder name. So can you please create another folder? Just give simple names. New folder, you can give H2K. Yeah. Okay. So now you can save that using system class hello. Okay, everything is right. Okay. So save it. File save as you need to go to that folder and yeah. And then wait a minute. Here you need to select all files. You have text documents, right? Select all files. And then give in double quotes. Give in double quotes file name as 1.cs in double quotes. In double quotes. Yeah, 1.cs. Click on save. Yeah. Okay, just verify whether it's saved or not. Yeah. Okay, great. So now when you save it like that, you can see in the type, what is it showing in the type? It is showing Visual C# source file. If it is a text file, it will not show like that. Okay, so all the students, please keep this in mind. You need to give double quotes and select all files to save it as .cs file. Yeah, thank you, Bhavik. So now you can compile it. So how to go to E drive? If your file is in E drive, so you need to click E colon. Right. Now what you need to do, CD space, you need to go to your folder, H2K. Right. Now how to compile, what is C# compiler? CSC space 1.cs. Perfect. So it is compiling now. Now you can see that in for Bhavik, one file has been added now. Okay. So now how to execute this file in command prompt? If you want to execute that file, you just need to type the exe file name. So just need to type one, one. Yeah. So you can see that hello world is created. So now go to your notepad again. Bhavik, go to your notepad again. So remove that semicolon at the end of console.writeline. Yeah, remove that semicolon, save it. Now we'll go back to the command prompt again, and now can you compile it again? CSC space file name. Our file name is 1.cs. Now you can see that I'm getting an error. So I'm getting exactly, it is telling which line, which column, what is wrong. So it is telling 6th line, 36th column, you are missing a semicolon, which is expected. See now, very good, right? It is telling you completely what you need to do. So that is how we can actually correct the errors. Okay, yeah, now you can correct it and then compile it again. So how to correct it? Go to your notepad, add a semicolon, and then save it, and then write your command again. CSC space 1.cs. Okay, great. Okay, so thank you very much, Bhavik. So I'll make the presenter role. Okay, so now any questions now, how to compile C# program? So only a couple of you who don't have advanced system settings, or who are not able to add in system settings or whatever, for them what they can do is, okay, so what they can do is they can view the complete path here. So instead of giving CSC space 1.cs, what they need to do is they need to give the complete path of this. So I'll tell how they need to do it. They need to go to version folder and then copy this path and then paste it here, and then slash CSC space, they need to give 1.cs. Okay, so okay, sorry, I need to share my screen. Sorry, I need to share my desktop. Yeah, so what I was telling here is, for those I'll repeat again because I have not shared my screen. So for those who don't have advanced system settings, what they need to do is they need to click on they need to go to this folder, copy this path, and then paste it here, and then give slash CSC space 1.cs. So all you need to do is you need to give the complete path of your compiler, C# compiler, and then give space, and then you need to give 1.cs. So that way you can compile it. So now it is compiling. So that is the difference. So for those who is able to do it in advanced system settings, they can simply type CSC. For those who are not able to do it, they need to give the complete path. So let me delete this and let me try to do it again. Let me open my command prompt again. Windows R CMD. I'm opening command prompt. So now what I can do here is, now I need to go to this path where my CS file is there. So go to D drive, go to CD H2K, and then what I need to do is copy the path where I have my .NET framework installed, and copy this, and then right click here and paste it. So you cannot press Ctrl V. If you press Ctrl V, it will just type this, it will show this. So you cannot press Ctrl V. If you want to paste it in command prompt, you need to right click and paste. Once you do that, you have to give your compiler name slash CSC space give your 1.cs. This is how you normally, so for those who are not able to do it, this is how you need to do. You need to give the complete path. Now I'll see the exe. So now how to execute it? I need to give 1. So I'm seeing hello world. Okay. So this is how we normally compile a C# program. Okay, one more thing which I need to tell is, along with your .NET framework, you will get 4 compilers. The compiler which you know already is C# compiler. So C# compiler is csc.exe. So now let's see what are the other compilers we have. So we have here VBC. So VBC is VB compiler. So I'll ask the questions again, so please listen. So VBC.exe is your VB compiler, and CSC.exe is our C# compiler, and we have something called, let me go back to exe files, give me a second. Yeah, okay. So the first compiler which we have here is csc.exe, which is your C# compiler. So the second one which we have is JSC, which is J# compiler. So we have C# compiler, we have J# compiler, we also have VB compiler. Okay, so VB compiler. So we have 3 compilers. So with .NET framework. So C#, J# and VB compilers, 3 compilers. So I repeat again, C# compiler is CSC, and J# compiler is JSC, and VB compiler is VBC. So now, can someone ping me the 3 compiler names? Can you guys ping me what are the names of the 3 compilers? VBC, CSC and JSC. Okay, so what is JSC stands for? JSC is for which compiler? JSE. It's not Java compiler. A lot of people will have confusion. JSE is JSAP compiler, not Java compiler. I repeat again, JSE is JSAP compiler. Okay. So now, one more question. Can you guys ping me where is the, what is the path for, yes, VBC is for VB compiler. VB stands for Visual Basic. VB compiler. CSE is for C sharp compiler. So now, can you please ping me what is the path for .NET framework, where I need to verify whether .NET framework, yeah, I said four compilers, sorry, it's three compilers. Yeah. .NET framework, you need to verify in SQL and Windows, Microsoft .NET framework and version 4.0. Okay, so now I'll ask some questions. So let me see who will answer. So, okay, I'm not seeing response from all of you. So I'll be happy if you respond to me. So now, WriteLine is a method which is present in which class? First question. WriteLine is a method which is present in which class? Yeah, console class. Okay. So now, C sharp is case sensitive. True or false? Yeah. All the namespaces are present inside your .NET framework folder. True or false? Yeah, it is true. We have okay. So namespace is collection of classes. So namespace is collection of classes. So is my voice breaking or is it clear? Yeah, okay. So now, how do you compile a C sharp file? CSE space, you need to give file name. So you need to compile using CSE space file name. Okay. How do you execute the file which is created? You just need to give file name. Okay. Or you can also give file name dot exe. Even that will work. Okay. How many compilers we have in how many compilers we get along with .NET framework? Yeah, along with .NET framework we get three compilers. I told four actually. I think we have only three compilers. Okay, so this is about introduction class. Okay, so now what we'll do is, so normally after every day I'll be sending the assignments for all of you. Which I'll be verifying. So you have to send me without fail before next class. I'll check out a way to do that, how to send to all of you the assignments. So let me show the assignment for day one. So ASP.NET assignments. So if you see here, so what is a namespace? What is BCL or FCL stands for? So I'll tell this, what is this? If you don't know the answer, anyway, you can, I'll anyway explain it in the next class, but if you don't know, you can Google and add this answer, but definitely I'll tell the answer in the next class. So console is a class present in system namespace, true or false? What is the path where .NET framework is installed by default? Write a simple C# program to print hello world, compile it and add here. So what are the three compilers which comes with .NET framework? What does DLL stands for? So like this, we have some questions. So ensure that you have to work every day. At least you need to spend around half an hour to 45 minutes. You have to send me all the answers for these questions so that I will feel like, okay, you are getting the concepts. Okay. So we'll figure out a way to send the assignments to all of you. Every day you'll be getting assignments like this. Day one assignments, day two assignments, day three assignments like this. Okay. So now, so I told like, what do we call all these things? I told inside this we have a lot of DLLs. So what do we call those DLLs? I told something sometime back. If you were able to, if you can able to recollect, all these DLLs we call it as, DLL stands for dynamic link library. Or what is DLL? Is it dynamic link library or data link library? Okay, I'll leave it to you. Anyway, you have to send this in the assignment. So my question is, what do we call all these DLLs? These are all libraries. These are all libraries. All these DLLs are libraries. So we call these libraries as, we can call this as framework class libraries. Framework class libraries. So all these are, in short, I'll just ping all of you. So we call all these DLLs as framework class libraries. Okay, for a week, we'll be having 3 classes per week. We can go for 1.5 hour per day, or even if all of you are fine, we can plan for 2 hours per day. I'm fine with either ways. So let me check with attendees. So are you fine with 1.5 hour, or you are good for 2 hours? Yeah, so I'm getting response like, let's have it for 1.5 hour. Or okay, yeah, otherwise you might feel like a bit bored because we don't even watch a movie for 2 hours, right? Yeah. Okay, so now, okay, so what does FCL stands for? Can all of you ping me FCL stands for? I just told sometime back, FCL stands for Framework Class Library. Okay, FCL stands for Framework Class Library. All these DLLs, whatever you see here, all these DLLs constitutes, these are all called library files, which can be reused. These constitute your framework class library, .NET framework classes library, or sometimes people even call this as BCL. So even sometimes you can call this as BCL. Can you guess what could be the expansion of BCL? It is base class library. Yeah, base class library. Okay. So that is the question which I have here. So what does BCL or FCL stands for? Base class library or framework class library? So can you? So I already told, like, we have a lot of namespaces. Okay. So all of you, please work on the assignments. Please send me without fail, because that gives confidence to yourself, and as well as a trainer, I feel like, okay, students are doing something. Okay. That gives some self-satisfaction. Okay, so I'll figure out a way to send this to all of you. And regarding the class, we can only have at 8:30 because most of the students are comfortable at 8 o'clock. So we'll be having at 8 o'clock. It might be difficult to move it to 8:30. Okay, yeah, 8 o'clock. Okay, and the first part of the session, Padmini, like, you have not missed much. When you started, that is where we started. It is, again, I'm not sure how many days. Normally it is for three classes per week. Okay, so I'm taking another course called database testing, which is planned for 3 days, and 3 days .NET. So if you are interested to go for 5 classes, yeah, we can plan for 2 hours. So even I thought of telling you with the break of 10 minutes, we can plan for 2 hours per day, because 3 classes per week, overall we can take 6 hours per week. So that the total course duration is 49 hours. So how is today's discussion? Like, am I going a bit faster, or you are able to get whatever we discuss? And you want me to go a bit slow, or please feel to send your feedback, so that we are going to go for 49 hours. I have to ensure that all of you are happy with the course. So I'll try to go a bit slower. Yeah. So this is my mail ID. If you have any suggestions, you can feel free to drop. So Yes. You will be getting assignments, real-time assignments. So send a mail to get the content, course content. You can drop a mail to training@h2kinfosys. So for this email ID, you can send your questions or clarifications which one you need, like weekly how many classes or whatever you need, any doubts regarding the course, you can just drop a mail to training@h2kinfosys. And regarding the feedback, like if you want me to go slower or anything, if you think if you have any suggestions for me, feel free to drop a mail to me, meghnath.h2kinfosys. I'll definitely try to implement that. Database testing is separate course which I am taking, which is separate. It's not related to .NET. Okay, so tomorrow we actually plan for a demo. So if you are happy with the course, I mean happy with the way we are discussing, please refer your friends. That way that will benefit us as well as H2Kinfosys as some referral policy as well. You will also get benefited. So it is, we can plan for certifications. So just a second.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.